Hello, it's Daizan here. So this is the stupa, the burial mound at the place where the Buddha passed into parinirvana, or died in conventional terms. We're at Kushinagar here, and you can probably hear various groups chanting as they circumambulate, as they kind of parade around the stupa, and we can do that too. You keep the stupa traditionally on your right side, and you kind of go around it chanting or meditating. And probably, I'm guessing, our walking meditation in a circle comes from this circumambulation of stupas. Other schools do walking meditation kind of in a line forward and back rather than circling. But this going around a stupa, very, very ancient and traditional. So when the Buddha died at this spot here, he was cremated. And there was quite a dispute over who got the relics. And so after a while, they decided to divide them, and different portions of his relics were put in different places. And so it's quite fitting, really, that we're doing the same thing with Shinzen Roshi's relics. So, but this was the spot, apparently, where the actual cremation happened. And you can read the full account in the Parinirvana Sutra, which is a very sort of moving story of his last days, his last teachings, and then what happened immediately afterwards. Now, one of the things with Zen Master Shinzen is we don't have his last words, but tradition records that we do have the last words of the Buddha. Apparently, he said that all conditioned things are impermanent. Strive on diligently. And that was his kind of summing up of his teaching. If we can recognize impermanence, if we can recognize the flow and shift of change of things and let go of our hanging on and grasping, then we can find liberation. And our job is to strive at this, to work hard at this, to diligently put this into practice. Shinzen Roshi would say exactly the same thing. I'm sure we could take this for his last words too. You can probably hear in the background, there's actually a few groups chanting at the same time at the moment. We have I think a Thai group, and I think probably a group from Taiwan, something like that. People at the stupa here put on, make offerings, lotus flowers and so on at the base, and they're also, in some people, putting on little bits of gold leaf, which you might just be able to see. This is, I think, a Thai tradition. I think the government doesn't like it much and has put up a few signs, but pilgrims will be pilgrims, I guess. So this is the Parinirvana spot, the place where the Buddha passed away, passed into liberation.